An unfortunate situation, no?
I've had worse.
Indeed, indeed. This is a very deep pit, and in this such a historic venue, I feel sure there may be valuable artifacts lurking in its depths.
I can't tempt you to jump down and look.
Well, this is my point. I feel you may be better qualified to examine its secret, unless you perished the thought, expired in the fall. Perhaps if you lighten your load a little, it may lessen the impact. The stone you carry?
Wondered when you'd get to that. Pull me up, and the stone's yours.
And we all leave happily ever after? I think not. give me your word that once you leave the pit, you will not lay a finger on me.
You have my word.
The stone? Now, Miss Croft, you gave me your word. Come now, Lara. Lara, you promised.
Boom.
Could you find it in your heart to help me up? I appear to be sleeping.
Pierre. You know nothing would please me more, but we have an agreement.
Agreement?
Not to lay a finger on you, remember, silly? Anyway, busy girl, got to go.
But I...
Don't let me hold you up.
Huh? And so ended the first of many. I'm sure Miss Croft would be the first to apologize for her not entirely courteous behavior regarding some of the more delicate religious artifacts, Father Patrick.
No need, my friend. All in a good cause. At least we knew they were in secure hands. And fortunately, the church was above sending a bulletproof envoy to retrieve them.
Ah, but she recognized her place in the great scheme. Some things, as history has illustrated, best left to their slumber. I speak in riddles. I talk of the stricken wolf ship.
Ah, the U-boat episode. Miss Croft would never enlighten me as to the details. For my own protection, she would often stress.
Indeed, Winston. And for this, you should be grateful. Deep in the bowels of their vessels lay one of the most powerful artifacts in all Christendom. An artifact which, when wielded at the vanguard of an army, would make that army invincible.
The Spear of Destiny.
But the boat never reached the Fatherland with its precious cargo. It disappeared from radar 3 weeks into the journey. This was the resting place of the 52 seamen, and also something much more sinister.
Whoa.